This is our Dharmshala. The higher roof is the newer part that was added in 1982. The lower part was one of the four original structures that were here during Baba's time. It was quite dilapidated at the time. It was the original officers' mess quarters. Now we call it the old Dharmshala. And this is where pilgrims stay. Off to the distance, you'll see a long bungalow. There are a number of doors. Those are small rooms. These are where residents live. And then to the right, you'll see a little house. This was Rhoda and Jimmy Mistry's house. Jimmy went to Baba a few years ago. Right here, you'll see, this is where the solar cooking is right here, where they cook rice and things for the Savage Kitchen. The Savage Kitchen is over here, where most of the residents, or a number of the residents that live here at Maribod, where we eat. We'll go around from the side and see. Here's some stairs going up to one of the roofs. We have tables up there, and you can sit and eat up there. There's a really nice one there under the tree. It's a beautiful tree. These here open up, and you can have a beautiful view of outside. There's Jeannie eating her lunch. Hi, Jeannie. We'll open them up so you can see how it looks. We have a large well right out here. It looks almost like a swimming pool. Want to come and see it, and then we'll go inside and see the rest since we're walking through the door. Look at it. Except it's way, the water's way, way down there. But you can see when there's lots and lots of rain and they put a lot of water in here, it's almost to the top where the railing is, and then it's just like a swimming pool. The kitchen is over this way now. This is where the women cook the food in here. We have a storage room over here where the grains are kept. And this is where they cook the chapatis and the bakris and wash the dishes here. Hey, Baba, guys. We're videoing. These are the women that cook here. That for the at the Savage Kitchen, they do the dishes over here.
You can just
stay here. Well, there. Okay, stay, Baba. Bye. This room, this building here, is adjacent to the Savage Kitchen. It is called the Spiritual Training Academy. It's one of our newer additions. This is where we have meetings and that sort of stuff. It's still quite new. We're going to get a lot of books for in here and that sort of stuff. We also have had, just recently we've had some Marathi classes, a little more Marathi class stuff. We have a couple of paintings. The one here was done, the one over here was done by John Perry from Australia. And then the one over here was done by Diana LePage for here. She just brought it when she was just here. And she's Charlie Morton's sister. Charlie's the one that did the painting that's in Baba's Samadhi. We have a room over here. Oh, do you see here? Baba Amy? Can you show that? We're sitting at the table. Okay, over here, this room is going, it's a small room. This is going to be where the TVs are going to be, VCR, so we can see the different tapes that are the monthly get plus tapes that on different issues, that sort of stuff. In this room here. All the new buildings in Maribod were designed and constructed under Ted Judson. Well, he designed them.
You can see the Spiritual Training Academy over there in the corner. And then this whole area, huge tents are put over here. And a couple hundred people, I think, stay in that alone during Amatithi. All these little structures that you see here will be used as bathrooms by the people that stay in the tents. And over here, and where they do their washing, I guess their clothes and that sort of stuff right along here. And they have a fire here to heat up the water, right in this little section here. This is during Amatithi, which we're getting ready for now. What we're seeing in the background, over here that we're facing, is Hostel D. And this is where many, many Indians come and stay. The cost is a lot less, and also the food is more Indian fare, rice and dal, chapatis, and hot spices. Our overflow also stays here, though they still eat at the Pilgrim Center. This is a short distance behind the Pilgrim Center. This is one side of Hostel D, though the entrance that usually uses on the other side. You can see how wide the verandas are. The Indians can often come in groups of 100, 150, and they can come, just give a notice that they're on their way, or they can just show up. This is the kitchen where they do the cooking for Hostel D. Hey, Baba. The preparation of all the foods and their device there. Let's go in and sit here too. Because he doing some of the cooking here and some of the cooking here. Hey, bye. They cook chapatis and bakri on here. Wash the dishes here. And when we go outside, we'll see the new buildings that they've built over here for the juice. Okay, well, while the door's open, let's see the dining hall. This is one of the bays of Hostel D, and they can put more beds in if they need, and they have cupboards right here, that they issue locks, of course, for the cupboards. A lot of our pilgrims stay here, but right now, all the Westerners, we just opened up Hostel C. We'll go to that in a minute, and you'll see where we put our, during the times of Christmas and New Year's, and actually, Baba's birthday, where we keep them.